website, and you see some of the past sermons on it. Friends in Christ, Jesus was quite a storyteller. He told stories as parables and others. It says to me there's about 40 parables scattered between the four Gospels. Some of the parables are pretty straightforward. It's almost like an Aesop fable where the moral of the story is X. But some of the parables have a lot of layers that can be peeled off of them. And a couple of good examples are the prodigal son and the good Samaritan. There's a basic story, but there's a lot beneath them that you keep peeling the story down. This morning's text is another one of these parables that I'm first hearing you point two parties, A and B, the Pharisee, the tax collector. But as you hear it, it's kind of like dealing with landmines. You know, every place you step, you've got to be careful, because is that really what it means, what it says? Now, the Pharisees were a religious group that believed that by following all the laws and rules of Moses and their modern interpretations, you would be righteous. You would be right with God. But they also set themselves aside from the communities so they wouldn't be tainted. On the other hand, the tax collector was a very disliked person. He was probably a Jew. He was a traitor because he was working for Rome. He was collecting money for those terrible Romans, that occupational force. Not only that, most tax collectors are credited as being thieves. They would collect X number of amount of money. But if they could get away taking more, they would do that. Remember the story of Zacchaeus. I will repay anybody I stole, took money from that I shouldn't, fourfold. Example of what happened. But as we hear this parable, we realize that the Pharisee is not able to really bless God's name. He gives thanks. He's really not able to experience God's amazing love, because it is me doing it, all these wonderful things. And so from Luke 18, starting with verse 9, Jesus told this parable to certain people who had convinced themselves that they were righteous and who looked at everyone else with disgust. And Jesus goes on. Two people went up to the temple to pray. One was a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood and prayed about himself with these words: God, I thank you that I'm not like everyone else, crooks, evildoers, adulterers, even like that tax collector. I fast twice a week. I give a tenth of everything I receive. But the tax collector stood at a distance. He wouldn't even lift his eyes to look toward heaven. Rather, he struck his chest and said, God, show mercy to me, a sinner. I tell you, this person went down to his home justified rather than the Pharisee. All who lift themselves up will be brought low, and those who make themselves low will be lifted up. Thanks be to God for his holy word. God, I thank you. Well, he starts out right. He's given thanks. But it kind of goes downhill after that, doesn't it? Thank you. I'm not like everybody else. I'm special. I'm on a pedestal. I'm a Pharisee. I got my righteousness because I do all these wonderful things. I'm not like that person or that person. I'm special. Now, it's simple to point fingers at the Pharisee and say, get a life, guy. But we are in danger of saying some of the same things. Thank goodness I'm not like somebody. And we can fall ourselves in the same old trap that I'm more superior than John Doe or Jane Doe. But that's not the point. We're all children of God. He complains about the crooks, the evildoers, adulterers, even the tax collectors. What he's forgotten is they are all children of God. We're all God's children. Whether we're young or not so young, we're God's children. We can't see what's in somebody's heart. We can see what they look like on the surface, but we can't tell what that person is really like, can we, just looking at them? And so the tax collector, on the other hand, is noted for being, in that culture, a bad person. Yet he experiences God's grace. The Pharisee never experiences that because, hey, I'm on a pedestal, I'm perfect. But this tax collector says, I'm a sinner, I know I am. And he opens himself up to that amazing love. He is blessing God's name. Now, the words that he says, God, show mercy to me, a sinner, has been taken by the Orthodox Church and turned into what's called the Jesus Prayer. We've talked about it other times. But it's a basic prayer that says, Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. We don't have to list all our sins. Sometimes that takes too long. But God knows them. And we're asking God for mercy, like the tax collector. But it's also a prayer that's easy to say, turn into an intercessory prayer. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on the Cole Schneider family. We don't know what all's going on in their lives, but we lift our prayer up to God to say, you know what's needed, be there and help them, please. And we can use that in such a wonderful way of sharing. But we can do that because we have experienced God's grace, God's amazing love. On the music video, we showed the crucifixion. Now, no person would ever go to be crucified voluntarily, except Jesus. Because he had a ministry to do, to give us eternal life, to forgive our sins, to help us live in community. That is God's amazing love is what makes this all possible. In some of this, in the last verse that talks about who will lift themselves up and grow low, and those who are make themselves low be lifted up. Reminds me of a song Mac Davis had a few years ago. Maybe some of you remember it. Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. I look in the mirror and I get better looking each day. To know me is to love me. I must be a heck of a guy. Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. And that's the attitude that the Pharisee had. And not just that Pharisee in the parable, but that group of people wanting to be close to God, but putting boundaries. If I only fast, if I only do this, if I only do that, I'm close to God. Instead of experiencing God's gracious love. The one video with the beautiful scenery in the background, blessed be your name. We can enjoy the beauties like that, can't we? We travel to places, we see wonderful sights. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We can give thanks that we see these beautiful things. That we don't wear blinders, that we can't see to the right or to the left, that we can look out. And then we have an attitude of gratitude, to thank God for his love for each and every one of us. That we are a part of this community of faith, a community of sharing, a community of love, and a community of lifting up others. And the life goes on, but we are God's children. We pray. pray for so many things, a safe harvest, unhealing, understanding, reconciliation, and the list goes on. But we can lift up our cares to the Lord, like the tax collector. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on Cole Schneider's family. Lord, have mercy on